Hi. Actually, after my previous video about the skylight computational design, some people ask me, is it possible to do the computational design for other kind of the skylights, such as SpaceFrame? I have to say yes. Actually, in the Grasshopper, there is no limitation. You can do any design. It depends on the actually your imagination. So on this video, I'm going to explain how we can do the skylight with the SpaceFrame, for example, a structure in Grasshopper by computational design. In this algorithm, actually my algorithm can calculate the kind of the tips of the element or pipes, for example, in a SpaceFrame, and also the type of the mirror for the different kind of the type of the mirror, and it can calculate it and gives you even the 2D production drawing as well at the simultaneously as you change the actually a SpaceFrame. All my algorithm needs is the single surface for inputting to the algorithm. After you input your first or single surface to the algorithm converts your surface to the SpaceFrame. Then you can change the size of the, for example, the length of that, for example, or the modulation, or the height of the actually SpaceFrame. Whatever, you can change it. And even if it is not completely a square or rectangle, it's okay. The algorithm can calculate that. And even you can make the curve, for example, a SpaceFrame. And also the algorithm can do the computational design for you. So watch this video. Okay, for a starting, I need a surface. So I design a surface in Rhino, and then I import it to my algorithm. As you can see, as I import my surface to the algorithm, it converted to the SpaceFrame. So I can change the size of the modulation, and I can, for example, change the size. I change my SpaceFrame right now, not as a surface and not as a flat one, as a curved surface. So as you can see, as I'm changing, the SpaceFrame also will change. So right now, this is my surface, and this is my SpaceFrame right now as a wireframe one. Now I'm going to convert it to the 3D. So right now it's going to be 3D file. And as you can see, there are some numbers on top of the mirrors. It is the ID of the mirrors. Those who has the same number, it means that they are actually completely tips. So they are the same mirror in different location. Now I also have a 2D production drawing as well with the all element extracted for the production drawing. And if you notice, some of the numbers are same, it means those two kind of mirrors are typical to each other. And this is the 3D file now. So if I just put some of the objects out, you can see that it's also subtracted the 3D geometry. Also here. This is the 2D production drawing with the lens ID and the number of the tips, and also this is the ID of the mirrors and the number of the actually that mirror. For example, from the ID to N5 we have 8 of that, and this is the whole algorithm. Different part, 3D geometry, making the mirrors convert into the 2D, and other part of the algorithm. And it's the final result.